Disney Cruise Line is known for having some of the most spacious and well-thought-out staterooms on board their ships. On my recent cruise on board Disney Dream, I booked a guarantee veranda. For those of you that don't know what a guarantee is, that means I did not get a room assignment at time of booking. Instead, I only knew that I would have a veranda room, but not the exact category and location. Sometimes a guarantee will get you a lower price, but in my case, that's all they had available. A few days before sailing, I was assigned a deluxe ocean view with veranda in category 5A. I was pleased as my room 10008 was unobstructed and located higher up on deck 10. Some rooms on Disney Dream will have what they call a navigator's veranda, where part of the view is obstructed by the ship's structure. At 246 square feet, including veranda, these rooms are a great size, especially if you have the maximum of 4 guests traveling. The queen-size bed was comfortable, and the side lamps with the not-so-hidden Mickeys were a fun touch. A nice feature is the bed is raised high enough to easily store luggage and even a collapsible stroller underneath. The sofa converts into a single bed, and there's also a pull-down berth above for a 4th guest with a nighttime starry sky surprise. These beds can be stowed away during the day to give more room to move around. There's also a curtain that can be used for separation between the bed area and the sofa bed, which is great if you have kids. Closet space is ample for hanging clothes, and there's also a cool slide-out safe for easy access to valuables. There are sets of drawers located outside the closet and in the desk dressing area console, and storage inside the sofa ottoman. The desk console also houses a mini fridge, power outlets, and the wave phones. The wave phones work all around the ship and on Disney's island of Castaway Key, and can be used to call and send and receive messages with others in your party, or allow staff in the kids club to keep in contact with you in case of any issues. The television has a variety of programming and tons of on-demand Disney movies and shows for no extra cost. The veranda, while a little on the small side, had enough room for 2 chairs and a table. The location of this specific room is on deck 10 forward and has a large extended overhang from the deck above. This by no means was an issue as far as the view was concerned, but the veranda will not get direct sunlight if that is important to you. Also, when standing at the railing, your forward view of the ship is slightly blocked by the ship's bridge wing, while the aft view is clear of any obstructions. The room also featured a split bathroom design. One section has a vanity, sink, and toilet, while the other has a vanity, sink, and shower and tub combo. Both sections are completely independent with their own doors, and this setup makes getting ready in the morning or evening much more efficient when the room is at full capacity. Virtually any room on Disney Cruise Line will be comfortable. Similar accommodations to this deluxe veranda are also available on Disney Wonder, Disney Magic, and Disney Fantasy.